Hey everybody, it's me, your old pal Dan Classic, and we're back at it again with another episode.
I'm not even going to ask.
Ask what?
Because every time I ask, I never like the answer.
Ah, come on, Jess. What about when we do wrestling figures? You like those, right?
Well, yeah.
And you like the military stuff, right?
Well, sure I do. You know, I was once a Navy SEAL.
Oh, really? I don't think you've ever mentioned it like 8,000 fucking times.
Well, it's true, Gorilla. Anyway, I guess it isn't always so bad.
That's the spirit.
It's not like there's possibly any more MEGO figures to review.
Yeah, for now, I guess.
All cheers to that.
MEGO Cheers! I'd forgotten all about it!
Aw, don't tell me they made MEGO Cheers figures.
They did.
Are they at least from the vintage line?
Nope.
Oh my god, new MEGO Cheers? How bad are they?
I don't know, but I bet they're dog shit. Anyway, we're gonna find out today, cause it's new MEGO Cheers! Raz Holly, hit the music!
Trying to buy some toys today, I spent everything I got. Being able to get some decent figures sure would help a lot. Wouldn't it be nice for me to pay a much fucking lower price if all the figures are so lame? But the price is still the same. MEGO Marty, now I see, he's playing us like a game. But I still wouldn't mind if the figures weren't all so lame. Blame it on Target and DC when the customers complain. But I still wouldn't mind if the figures weren't all so lame.
As we've discussed in previous episodes, MEGO, the one-time action figure behemoth that went broke in the early 80s, only to be revived in 2018, used that revival to release some of the oddest choices of licensed 8-inch clothed figures. One of those odd choices was Cheers. Now, you could argue that Cheers is one of the most successful sitcoms of all time, and a company banking on nostalgia could do a lot worse than Cheers for a well-known license, which I'm sure wasn't expensive at all. But in true new MEGO form, we took a TV show with an ensemble cast of like 9 fucking people and seemingly picked 3 at random to make figures for. Just 3 and moving on. Before we go into who they did make, let's go over who they didn't. Now, I'm not privy to how the likeness rights or any of this shit would work, but if there's a situation where you couldn't get permission to make some shit the right way, then you should just drop the whole goddamn thing and focus your resources on something else. But what do I know? So let's take a look at who didn't make the cut for Cheers MEGO figures. First, there's no women at all. Not that the women new MEGO figures have been so fucking stellar, but for a show that had 2 or 3 women as central characters, it's odd that we couldn't at least get Shelley Long as Diane or Kirstie Alley as Rebecca. It would be wishful thinking at this point for MEGO to have maybe wanted Rhea Perlman as Carla, even though she was a central character that appeared in nearly every episode. But moving on. Moving on to the dudes, that is, who round out the next 3 missing in action. First up, the coach. No, the other one. Then there's Kelsey Grammer as Fraser Crane. I mean, why would you want to get a character so successful that he was spun off into his own super successful series? And finally, the character you would think would be least likely to get cut, Ted fucking Danson as Sam Malone, the central goddamn character of the show. What gets on my nerves is that we see stuff like this from MEGO, and then the booger eaters online continue to praise the company and speculate how great it would be for MEGO to take on whatever fill-in-the-blank license. Personally, if this is how MEGO handles super popular successful properties, then they can stay far fucking away from my favorite shit. But I digress. That leaves us with 3 characters that did make the cut. First up is George Went as Norm Peterson. I'm sure John Wilde was pleased as punch to see the fat body make an appearance in the line. Next is John Ratzenberger as Cliff Clavin. At least we got two characters so far that go together, and honestly, if I was going to make the cut down to three, it's hard to argue against Cliff and Norm. But finally, and strangely, the last character we got from MEGO, and the one that seems to be more sought after of the three, is Woody Harrelson as Woody Boyd. It almost seems like they threw three darts at a board, they landed on these guys, and away we went. Anyway, enough speculation on how the business geniuses over at MEGO came up with the roster. I got all three of these odes to alcoholism, so let's check them out!
Okay, so here we go. We have the three characters that did make the cut. Cliff Clavin, Woody Boyd, and Norm Peterson, all here in the package. Let's go ahead and start with Cliff Clavin. He is dressed in his traditional postman outfit. Did he have a hat? I don't know. Maybe. Well, he obviously did not come with one. They all come with a beer that has the Cheers logo on it, and that's not bad. And another thing that's not bad about these is that they actually got the likeness rights for the actors who played the characters. So, of course, we do have a pretty good resemblance to the actors who played them. These are the older boxes that still say 8 and up. This is before we knew the dangers of 8-inch action figures and what they pose to small children. They all come with the little catchphrases, too. He's a, hey, it's a little-known fact that the tan became popular in what is known as the Bronze Age. Whew, okay. Yeah, your typical, 14 points of articulation, a limited edition action figure with original detail and quality. TV favorites, Cheers, we have on the back some awesome Google search pictures we found of Woody Boyd, Norm Peterson, and Cliff Clavin, all in different sizes, different scales. That's great. And our beautiful MEGO stripes, and then the Wild West fucking font for our typical blurb of bullshit on the back here, and the trivia, of course, the trivia on what television game show did Cliff make an appearance. The answer is Jeopardy. And then, of course, we have our Marty MEGO blurb. You know, we haven't looked at these in a while, the blurb. I usually cut away and we show Marty MEGO laughing and carrying on. And I want to kind of go back over this again and read through it if you haven't already seen this. Marty Abrams, a.k.a. the father of the action figure. Now, that is seriously debatable. has relaunched these figures in response to overwhelming demand. See, I always kind of gloss over that because the first part is so ridiculous. Was there overwhelming demand for Cheers figures? Was there? Let me know. Let me know down in the comments. Tell me how many people were clamoring for fucking Cheers. And don't give me that bullshit that Target demanded that Cheers and Facts of Life and these other bullshit fucking brands that nobody wanted were going to be made into figures. And if they did make a Married with Children fucking license or a Married with Children figures, they weren't going to pay for the fucking for the likeness rights so that the figures could be shitty as possible and sit in fucking in clearance. No, I don't believe that. So there's never really been any actual corroborating evidence to prove any of that shit. Some of it may be true, but who cares? Moving on. MEGO, pronounced MEGO, which is true, was started by his father David Abrams in 1954 and named by his younger brother Howard, who would say MEGO too. Howard later became head of sales for the company, MEGO Corp. And we don't see Howard's fucking picture on the goddamn box. You know, he goddamn named the company, but whose fucking visage gets to don every single package? It's me, Marty MEGO!
Yeah, that's who gets to fucking do it. It sold, oh, so, all right, head of sales of the company, MEGO Corp, sold over 20 million of its now standard 8-inch action heroes worldwide, and MEGO Corporation is proud to take over that fine heritage today. Let's back it up a little bit. 20 million of its now standard 8-inch action heroes worldwide. So stop telling me that they're rare. There's fucking 20 million of those things floating out there, not to mention the things that sat in warehouses after the fact. So all those old figures or whatever, and they did, they sold a lot. Those things were very successful. That's why we're sitting here with these today, because they certainly aren't making it on their own fucking accord. Okay, moving on to Woody Boyd. Woo. I mean, look at him. He's yeah. Now this is the package is a little messed up, so it's kind of hard to tell what his face looks like. But it's gonna be. I'm not fucking hopeful. Wow. Whoa. What the fuck is he, a tiger? What's with the fucking anyway? Hey, Mr. Peterson, there's a cold one waiting for you. Hey, I'm stupid. I'm Woody. and we have the photos on the side. It's the same old shit on the back here in the last season of Cheers. What local government position was Woody elected? The answer, city council. Moving on. Finally, we have in the Type 2 MEGO fat body. Is our friend and yours, Norm Peterson. Drinking all day is the norm. Oh, yes, also comes with a mug of beer. And there he is, George Wendt, fucking represented. He looks drunk in his fucking suit's all fucked out. His eyes crossed. His feet are all fucking twisted up in the box. Yeah, he looks like he's fucking blasted. Same shit on the back. We do have a trivia question. In the series finale, what institution does Sam call on to calculate Norm's tab? Answer? NASA. And to be fair, Cheers was a very, very popular series. One that I'm not super familiar with. It's been in reruns for... ages and ages. Speaking of ages dating up, let's take a look at these fucking figures outside of the box. These figures for ages 8 and up that come with mugs of beer. All right, so let's go ahead and start with Cliff Clavin. And as you can see, he can hold his fucking accessory. Wow, is that a first? Is that a first? I think the Leatherface figure can, but that figure came later. For the first wave of these MEGO figures, look, it's a figure that can hold the fucking thing that it came with. Isn't that awesome? He has his little mail carrier outfit that actually looks pretty legit. This isn't not the worst thing in the world. There are a couple problems with it. Let's go ahead and look at his hair. That looks less like some gray hair on the temples as much as it looks like somebody fucking, he put some fucking cocaine in there or something. Like there's some errant flower fucking floating around the bar got into his hair. Like it's very poor job in kind of adding the extra paint to the hair. It's the traditional fucking MEGO body. 14 points of articulation. That's true. And these aren't bad bodies. They're pretty solid. Like they're hard to break. They're not easy to pose. They still have that problem where the fucking the shoulder thing will hook out the outside and the shoulder will become disconnected, and then you may end up having to restring it. They can be restrung, but I mean, here's the point. I'm gonna get to that here in a second, but let's look at the rest of the fucking figures before I start yelling. All right, that's him. All right, and there's Woody. It looks fucking, does this look like Woody Harrelson? It looks like fucking Woody Harrelson's fucking goofy cousin or something. Like, oh my. and then what's with the hair? He has yellow stripes in his hair. Whose hair looks like this in real life? This obviously, if I really gave a shit about it, would need to be repainted. But since I don't, and since I don't plan on making a fucking custom for, I don't know, Kingpin or fucking White Man Can't Jump. I figure this is just gonna, hey, he's got some jeans and some boots for fucking custom fodder, and they all come with the glass of beer. But yeah, that's Woody. Finally, we come to Norm with the John Wilde's favorite, the type 2 fat body, and he's super loosey-goosey. I think he's broken already, so that'll be fun. He can hold his accessories. It does kind of look like the actor. It looks like George Wendt, right? That's his name? Fucking, who cares? He's got a cross eye. It looks like his face is like fucking somebody took it and mangled the goddamn thing. At the end of the day, when you're looking at these things, they're not the worst goddamn things in the world. But who the fuck were they made for? Who the fuck, we're gonna introduce MEGO, these 8-inch clothed figures, these great, historic, awesome fucking figures to a brand new audience of kids, ages 8 and up, and what are we gonna do for them? Cheers, The Facts of Life, Charlie's Angels, fucking name it. How many fucking Married with Children? How many fucking old fucking piece of shit sitcoms can we get the license to cheaply and just fucking whip out as many bad figures as possible? The shit didn't work until they fucking got off their asses and actually started making good figures that made sense, that people might want to fucking buy. This shit was not working, and that's the my big problem with it, is that motherfuckers won't fucking admit that. That as far as what these are fucking good for, they're just custom fodder. I'm gonna do something with Cliff later on, but I got an idea for fucking Norm right now. All right, and so there he is. I've taken the clothes off of him. All this crap gone. I'm gonna use that later for something else. But I had fucking need of a fat body. And I know what you're saying. You've already got a fat body. Hey, fuck you. Anyway, this is the fucking type 2 fat body that John Wilde is positively wild about. We're not using this. We're gonna get this fucking head off of here. Get the fuck out of here. Yeah, we're not gonna need that for anything. I don't know what the fuck we would do with that anyway. Maybe to make some sort of fucking monster character. So there's that. But I was gonna use this body because I have this. There he is. It's the king of rock and roll, Elvis motherfucking Presley. I also got this a while back. It actually came in a box that was already opened. Like, it was like stupid fucking Amazon. They can't fucking ship stuff for shit. You think, being so big and fucking popular and making so much goddamn money, they could ship shit properly, but like the fucking came and like the bubble was popping out right off of it. So this was actually the first MEGO I ever opened of the new ones. And look at this. Got the painted on little widow's peak. He looks more like Kurt Russell, honestly, than Elvis Presley. And my main problem with this is that when Elvis wore this outfit, he didn't look like this. He didn't have fucking abs of steel and shit. This ain't Jailhouse Rock Elvis. It's Fat Elvis. So we're gonna use this fucking body, and we're gonna make fucking Fat Elvis right now. All right, and so here's what he really looked like in that era. With the fat body. See, now I'm coming around, John. John Wilde, hey, I'm coming around to the benefits of the fat body. Now we can make improvements on our MEGO figures. So there it is, a bonus MEGO figure here, a bonus MEGO custom here in MEGO episode 6. There it is, MEGO Cheers.
Well, that's it for MEGO Cheers. Give us your opinions in the comments below. We'd really like to know what you think.
I think I need a drink after sitting through that.
Well, here's to you, Jess.
And here's to anybody else but MEGO.
Raz Holly, hit the music!
Shut up, Duke. Dang.